With Jeb Bush all but jumping into a presidential race against Hillary Clinton, how are the media treating the growing group of 2016 contenders? Frank Luntz put that question to a focus group.
I honestly don't think that the media even lets everyone know who's running. I think everyone here can't even name every candidate that's running for president.
Plus, it all depends on what network you're watching. If you're watching CNBC, it's going to be pro-Democrat, and if it's Fox, it'll be pro-Republican.
How does the media cover Hillary Clinton? Do you think they treat her fairly?
If you look at, for the most part, she's the media darling at the moment. They've already practically coronated her as the 2016 winner.
That is not true. They picture Hillary in bad lighting.
I would respectfully disagree. Mrs. Clinton gets a free ride.
I spoke with him earlier from Phoenix. Frank Luntz, welcome.
Thank you.
Let's start with the coverage of Hillary. We hear she's being coronated. No, she's being shown in bad lighting. What do you make of such divergent views?
A man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest. That old Simon and Garfunkel song, if you like Hillary Clinton, you think that the press isn't giving her a fair shake. If you dislike her, you've got a completely different point of view. The problem is that the public wants to be affirmed rather than informed. And that's always been the challenge for the media. And Howie, what's different with Hillary is that people, they look at the camera angles. They look at how she's dressed. No other candidate do they take into account what's going on outside of what she's saying. And that's an asset to Mrs. Clinton, but it's also a liability.
So I hear people in your focus group saying CNBC, probably meant MSNBC, is pro-Democrat, yeah. Fox is pro-Republican, and you're saying it's in the eye of the beholder. But people tell pollsters they want the facts, they want fair and balanced coverage. But what I hear from you, Frank, is that if they have strong opinions about politics, not so much.
Well, what they say and what they actually respond to are two different things, but I'm going to give you some specifics. 2 points. They want to see things side by side. So let me see what the candidate said 4 years ago and what the candidate is saying today. Or let me see what candidate A is saying about the issue, and then let's see what candidate B is saying. You give me that side by side comparison, and you're giving me substance. You're giving me the ability a decision. Do I trust them and do I agree with them? That side-by-side coverage, which is rarely done on any news network, it's rarely done in print, that's what the public is looking for, and it's just not happening.
When you talk about, when we heard one of your focus group people in that audience talk about everything is reduced to sound bites and snippets, in other words, it's very superficial, not everything, but I think the media have to plead a little guilty here because we do get caught up in the flap of the day and the embarrassing soundbite gaffe and that sort of thing.
And in fact, polling, which affects my profession, if I produce a poll that shows a long shot suddenly in the lead, everyone's going to run to it. Everyone's going to report it. And it's just one simple poll. I think you have to make a judgment. What genuinely informs people, either who's up and who's down, or why they're up and they're down. But the danger is when the media takes a single snippet or a single polling result and then blows it out of proportion. It's the reason why the media has lower credibility today than at any time in recent history, and it's a lesson to them before 2016. Get your act together now, even before voters are paying attention.
Well, I was going to say, this really sounds like a flashing red light for those of us in the political coverage business going into what's sure to be a very divisive and controversial and important campaign. But at the same time, if every single thing that we put on the air could be weighed on a scale, some of your people would still say, oh, they're giving Hillary a free ride. Oh, no, they're being very tough on Hillary, or Mitt, or Jeb, or Rand.
Some of this is the public's own fault because they don't pay attention until the last few weeks. Some of it is that they're just not sophisticated, so they don't know the issues. That person who said CNBC, they probably don't know the difference between CNBC and MSNBC. But in the end, we can only judge what we know based on what you tell us. So Howie, it's even more than a flashing red light. It is, wake up. You have a responsibility. It's an awesome responsibility, but you got to get it right. It is better to err on the side of substance than style. It is better to give us a little bit more than a little bit less. And remember that in the end, whatever you give us is how we're going to decide how we're going to vote.
Good advice and strong responsibility for the media here heading into this campaign. Frank Luntz, thanks very much for joining us.
Thank you.